Grab your Bibles, grab your swords. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We thank God for our praise team. We
Amen.
Thank God for our Hallelujah. Amen. For our Levites on today. We thank God for our brother Larry. Amen. Come on and praise God, church. Y'all are alive out there. Come on. I need y'all to help me today. I had a rough week.
Amen.
Y'all need to help me today. Amen. Jesus had to carry me through this week. I need somebody to help me. Praise God today. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
Luke chapter 7, you have it. Everybody's already standing. Luke chapter 7.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. We thank you, Jesus. We praise you. Luke chapter 7, verse 36. When you have it, say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say big trust. Y'all remind me of that. I'm going to say, don't let me forget to tell you about the big trucks. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Luke chapter 7, verse 36. And it reads, and one of the Pharisees desired him that he would eat with him. And he went into the Pharisee's house and sat down to meat. And behold, a woman in the city, which was a sinner, when she knew that Jesus sat at meat in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster box of ointment and stood at his feet behind him weeping and began to wash his feet with tears and then wiped them with the hairs of her head and kissed his feet. Somebody say she kissed his feet.
Kissed his feet.
And anointed them with the ointment. Now when the Pharisees which had bidden him saw it, he spake within himself, saying, this man, if he were a prophet, would have known who and what manner of woman this is that touches him. For she is a sinner. And Jesus answering said unto him, Simon, I have somewhat to say unto thee. And he said, Master, say on. There was a certain creditor which had two debtors. The one owed 500 pence and the other 50. And when they had nothing to pay, he frankly forgave them both. Tell me therefore, which of them will love him most?
Right.
Simon answered and said, I suppose that he to whom he forgave most. And he said unto him, thou hast rightly judged. And he turned to the woman and said unto Simon, thou see this woman, seest thou this woman? I entered into thine house. Thou gave me no water from my feet, but she has washed my feet with tears and wiped them with the hairs of her head.
All right.
Thou gavest me no kiss, but this woman, since the time I came in, has not ceased to kiss my feet.
Yes.
Amen.
My head with oil thou didst not anoint, but this woman has anointed my feet with ointment. Wherefore I say unto thee, her sins, which are many, are forgiven.
Yes.
For she loveth much, but to whom little is forgiven, the same loveth little.
Hallelujah.
And he said unto her, thy sins are forgiven.
Yes.
And they that sat at meat with him began to say within themselves, who is this that forgiveth sins also? And he said to the woman, thy faith has saved thee. Go in peace. Let us pray.
Amen.
Father God, we praise your holy name. Lord, we worship you and we magnify your name. You are worthy to be praised. Lord, we give you the glory, the honor, and the praise just because of who you are. We thank you for your love. We thank you for your mercy, oh God. Lord, we thank you for your grace. Lord, we thank you, Lord, hallelujah, for your hand upon our lives. And Lord, we ask, Father God, that you will speak, oh God, hallelujah, into the ear base of your people, oh God. Hallelujah. Use me, your woman servant, for your glory. Lord, save souls, change lives, set the captives free, open the eyes of the blind, oh God. Encourage the discouraged on today, God. Release the sinners, oh God. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. From under the bondage of sin, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we ask that you will have your way in this place, oh God. In the name of Jesus, Lord, not our will, but let your will be done, God. As you have already ordained in heaven, let it be done today. Let it be done now, oh God. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus, bless those in the sanctuary. Bless those out on media, social media, those listening on Facebook, those who will listen on YouTube later, oh God. Lord, bless, oh God, each and every person that hears your word, God.
Yes.
Somebody needs to hear from you on today,
yes,
God. So Lord, we say, have your way. Holy Spirit, move. Somebody say, Holy Spirit, move. Holy Spirit, move. Ha, in this place, have your way, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And after it's all said and done, oh Lord, we will be ever so careful to give you and you only the glory, the honor, and the praise. And it's in the precious, matchless name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, that we pray. And let the church say, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Tell somebody to look a little closer.
Somebody
say it out loud. Say, look a little closer. Hallelujah. Look a little closer. Amen. Hallelujah. You sometimes, as you're going through life, you have to take another look. Paul says sometimes we're looking on the surface of things. And we often have to go deeper and delve deeper into what's really going on. Somebody say, look a little closer. This woman that was a sinner, she was not invited to the party. She was not invited to the dinner, but she showed up anyway. She came to the dinner where the Pharisee had invited Jesus to come, and Jesus came to the house of the Pharisee, and they're sitting at the table, and they're having dinner, and this woman shows up. And what they saw was a woman showing up, but they were only looking at the surface of things. What they saw was a woman who was a sinner, but they only were looking at the surface of things. And sometimes people will look at you, and they will look at me, and they will judge us according to what they see, but they are often only looking on the surface of things. Every time we see something, what we see is not always what we see. Amen. Hallelujah. I just want to know if y'all paying attention. Amen. Everything that you see is not really what you see. In other words, what's really going on in the factual world is not what's going on in the spiritual world. God has a greater plan. God says, for I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. So no matter what's going on in your life today, no matter what you're facing, there is hope. Tell somebody there's hope.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. There's hope for your future. It's not over until God says it's over. It's not over until God says it's over. This is not the end of the road. We have to often press our way like this woman did, press our way to Jesus.
That's right.
Pressed her way to Jesus because I believe that there were some things that she needed resolved within herself.
That's right.
I don't think it was about the crowd. I don't think it was about the Pharisees, but I think that there were some things that this woman needed from God for herself.
Yes.
Has there ever been a
yes.
time in your life where you needed
yes.
some things from God for yourself?
Yes.
Your neighbor
yes.
couldn't do it. Your boo couldn't do it. Bae couldn't do it. Hubby, your wife couldn't do it. Your children couldn't do it for you, but you
yes.
had to press your way to
yes.
God for
yes.
yourself. You had to come. You couldn't do it by hearsay. You couldn't hear what they said about Jesus. But you had to make your way to Jesus because you needed Jesus to give you some direct answers.
Amen.
It could not be indirect. It could not be by hearsay. It could not be because he blessed my sister or my brother. But I needed him to come see about me.
Amen.
Has anybody ever been in a place in your life where you needed Jesus to come see about you?
Yes.
When you
yes.
thought you were at the end of your rope, which way was up, which way to go. Every which way you turned, there was opposition. Every Jesus. But she came to the feet of the Lord, my God. She was like the woman with the issue of blood who said, if I could just touch the hem of his garment,
yes,
I know I'll be made whole. If I could just get to Jesus, if I got to crawl, I'll get there. If I got to cry, I'm going to get there.
Yes. But the ointment, the perfume that was in the box was very expensive. And this woman was willing to pour out everything that she had at the feet of Jesus. Somebody needs to hear God on today. God wants us to pour out everything that we have at his feet. I often ask people, are you sold out for Jesus? Right.
I want to ask you today, are you sold out? Is your all on the altar of sacrifice laid? Have you made up your mind that you want to follow Jesus? No matter which way you got to go, no matter how hard it is, because nobody ever said that the road was going to be easy. But you got to make up your mind that I'm going to stick with Jesus. Hallelujah. This woman had a revelation, and that's what we have to do. We have to have a revelation of who God is in our lives.
Yes.
See, my deliverance, your deliverance comes through your revelation. The Bible said this woman was a great sinner. Jesus said she had been forgiven of much, of many sins. Now, you got anybody here ever, I guess I'm not talking to no sinners in the house of God. I guess I'm not talking to anybody who's ever been delivered from anything.
Yes.
If God ever delivers you from anything, go ahead and give God some praise. Over and think about all the mess you did. Christ.
That's
he
right.
already said we've been delivered and set free. He already said we were redeemed from the blood, by the blood, redeemed from our sin. He already said we were what? New creations in Christ Jesus. Therefore, if anyone be in Christ, he or she is what? A new creation. Come on, somebody. Elizabeth and had to come back here to Hillside. And as I'm traveling, I just saw a whole bunch of big trucks getting in my way. Just trucks getting in front of me. Every road that I got on, there was a big truck. Even coming back, almost coming back, as I turned from Elizabeth, there was a big truck. As I turned off of 22 into Hillside, there was a big truck. And I said, these big trucks, and they were driving slowly, and they were taking up the whole road. See, what you got to understand, I'm in a vehicle, I'm in a car, and the big truck, that's another vehicle. And you have to understand that vehicles are what God uses to transport his ministry. So as I'm moving forward with the ministry, these big trucks were being used to block my way. Hallelujah. They were being used to slow me down. See, somebody needs to hear God on today. And the closer I got to my destination, the bigger the truck was. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Come on, come on. Because we got faith. Come on, we got new faith. We got pistis faith. We got unshakable faith. We got bulldog faith. We won't back up. Come on. We not backing down. Come on. We're moving forward. Somebody say, boom. This is the year of breakthrough. This is the year, come on, of opportunity. This is the year of open doors. This is the year of manifestation. Come on, church. Somebody say, boom. Come on, say, boom. My God, it's the revelation of who he is that keeps us moving forward. My God, hallelujah, hallelujah. It's the revelation of who he is that keeps us getting up from out of the bed every day. It's the revelation of who he is that keeps us believing that things are going to get better. My God, that I don't have to wait, but now faith is the substance of things hoped for. That things are getting ready to get better now. Somebody say now. Now, God. I don't know what you believe in God for, but somebody better put a now on it. Somebody got to say now, God. I'm believing you to move now. I'm believing you to move in this situation now. I don't believe I have to wait for the week next. I don't believe I have to wait for tomorrow. But I say, woman who has no name had a revelation of who God was, and she kept that in the forefront of her mind as she went to Jesus. She knew that Jesus was God. She knew that Jesus came to bring deliverance. She knew that Jesus came as a solution to her, whatever the problem was that was related to her sin. Oh my God. See, some of the stuff that we do, my God, we don't do it just because we feel like doing it. We do it as a band-aid, as an anesthetic, anesthesia for what's really going on underneath. My God, hallelujah. Some of us do some of the stuff that we do. So we spend so much time preaching against the behavior when God wants to heal the condition that's pushing us towards the behavior. Do y'all hear me on today? We spend a lot of time talking about what we're doing, but God wants to heal what's going on the inside that makes us do what we do. I'm not just talking about drinking and drugging. I'm talking about just being mean. Some of us are just mean. Oh my God. Oh my God. I totally lost my temper yesterday, amen, because I had come to the limit, my God. I was under pressure. See, and what I had allowed myself to do was not spend time in prayer. My God. Hallelujah. My tradition is to go to prayer every morning when I come downstairs from my bedroom to hit my knees and pray. And I had let the devil tell me, you already anointed. It don't take all of that. You can go and sit on the couch and pray. You don't have to read your Bible as soon as you come downstairs in the morning.
Oh my God.
See, the devil is a liar.
Amen.
See, and the truth is not in him. Amen. physical, natural enemies. But we have to understand that we have a supernatural enemy. And he's called Satan. And he uses people to get us off course. Hallelujah. To make us think that it does not take all of that. You ain't got to praise God like that. You ain't got to pray every day. You ain't got to read your Bible all the time. Somebody say the devil is a liar.
And
the truth is not in him.
Devil is a liar. Amen. That's right.
See, my purpose is wrapped up in the revelation of my God who releases the power for my purpose. See, and I can only get that power for my purpose by going to my God to sit at his feet, amen, hallelujah, to open my Bible, to hear the preached word, to pray in my heavenly language, to believe God for breakthrough, and believe God. See, what I started to do during this time of testing, I said, don't test God. Tell somebody don't test God.
Don't test God.
I said, I'm going to try this. I said, see if what they're saying is really true. I said, let me just take a break. Let me just sit on this couch. I'm tired. And I sat on that couch, and the devil came in like a flood.
Tell
it. Came in like a flood. You hear me?
Yes, he will.
And once he got in, I started focusing on flesh. See, the Bible says that we are cursed when we lean on the arm of flesh.
Amen.
But we are blessed when we trust in God.
Amen. Amen. That's right. That's right.
My God, my God. So I started looking at everybody and looking at everything, looking at Pastor Anthony, and then I started complaining. My God, hallelujah, da-da-da-da-da, can I be honest up in here? Come on. And I'm da-da-da-da-da-da-da, and I'm not feeling too spiritual. Oh, glory, can I get a witness?
Amen.
I'm not feeling too spiritual. I just want to tell somebody off, and he happened to be the closest person to me. Hallelujah. But how many of you know that when Pastor Emily went to bed that night, I started feeling real messed up. The devil will torment you. Listen to me, church. The devil began to torment
me. Will.
And he said, you ain't happy. You know you want to be married no more. Come on. That's when I started getting, the devil started getting my attention. I've been married for 29 years. And I'm crying. I open my Bible. sat down and meditated on scripture. I mean, I'm always hearing the word, always hearing the preach word on the TV, but it's something about your private time.
That's right. That's
and
right.
And I'm up in the day, and I'm sitting there weeping. And it carried over to last night. And I'm sitting there weeping over the scriptures and weeping over the text. And I'm feeling like the woman with the issue of blood. And I'm feeling like, oh Jesus, I love you so much. I just love you. Does anybody love him like that?
Amen.
No, wasn't there that I could just really be open with and say, I feel like losing my mind. I had to keep going to God.
Yes.
Y'all gotta hear me.
Yes. Amen.
And the devil tried to deceive me to make me think that wasn't enough. But let me tell you today, it was enough.
Amen.
Like the satisfaction I got when I came back and talked to God.
That's
come
right.
Come on and give God some
amen.
Praise.
Amen.
Come on and worship Him.
Amen.
Come on and worship Him.
Yes.
Come on
yes.
and praise. When you have a realization of what God does for you and what he has already done, then there's a release of peace. Then you can, like Jesus told the woman, this woman came and she's pouring out and she's washing his feet and she's kissing his feet, and his feet were dirty because they wore sandals back in the day. And Jesus said that God never gave him water to wash his feet. He never did anything to greet Jesus. He didn't give him a kiss when he came in. He didn't anoint his head with oil, as was the tradition back then when somebody came to your house. Because what he was doing was rejoicing in the presence of Jesus and making Jesus feel on, like he making him feel like Jesus was on the same level as him. Amen. See, church, that's the danger that we face as Christians.
So,
because God is a God of relationship.
Amen.
We cannot make God feel like he's on the same level as
amen.
Us.
Amen, that's right.
We
that's
have right. to bow down. Somebody say bow down.
Bow down.
We have to bow down. My God, bow down at his throne. You know, I put a post up about Christians not going to church.
Yeah.
Christians don't want to go to church anymore. They want to stay home and watch it on TV or watching on the internet, and thank God they're watching the word, but there's something about being in the congregation.
That's right.
See, if you're watching it, if you're only watching, then you are not participating. Come on. If you're watching, then you're not bringing your tithes to the storehouse. If you are watching, you're not bringing your gifts to the church. God says that there are gifts in the house that he wants to use.
That's right.
For the edifying and equipping of the saints.
Amen.
For the work of the ministry. Yes. And see, the problem today is a lot of us are doing the work of the ministry, but we have not been equipped. Oh my God. My divine alignment. That's not the way I ordained it. Amen. Everybody should be accountable to somebody.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
That's how you get a Jim Jones making people drink poison. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
That's how you get pastors that feel it's okay to sleep with everybody in the congregation and nobody can sit him down or sit her down. Oh, I wish y'all would hear me.
Amen.
There's a divine order, and God wants us to be equipped for the ministry so that we can do the work of the ministry.
Amen.
So somebody say everybody has something to do.
Everybody has something to do. Amen.
Everybody has something to do. Even if you're just encouraging somebody. I love the way Sister Carmen walked over and began to greet the brother. She didn't even know Sister Keita. I saw you go over and feel you went over. And everybody, you don't know, people go and they don't have anybody to hug them. They never talk to nobody all week long. They like this woman, they feel like outcasts. My God. And God is saying, I need the church to be my arms. I need y'all to be the ones to love on each other.
Yeah.
If you go on social media, you got all kinds of negativity mixed in with the word.
Yeah.
And God says, I need you to come to a place where you will be holy. Being holy means set apart, that I'm consecrated, that I'm taking this Sunday and I'm going to church. Come on, somebody. And we shouldn't even have to preach this day. But God is saying, I need my church to be the church. See, there was a time in the neighborhood when you would see everybody walking around with their Bible. They were going to church on Sunday.
That's right.
They were going to church on Sunday morning. Now we think it's too much to even carry a Bible. My God. I mean, everybody has the Bible on their phone. But sometimes we think it's too much to even open our Bible app on the phone. We got to stop being lazy with God. We got to stop holding back on God, church. We want God to do so much for us. But my God, God is saying, what are you going to do for me? God is saying, what are you going to sacrifice for me? God is saying, I know this is a hard teaching, my God. But we got to be the church so we can make a difference in our communities, church. We have to be the church so we can make a difference in our families. We got to be the church so we can stay married. We got to be the church. Don't shout me down, but go ahead and give God a praise. We got to be the church. What he's done for you. Jesus said this woman was forgiven of much, and this woman loves me much. My God, we never get to a place where we don't need him.
Amen.
I know I got some witnesses in the house. You say, I never get to a place where I don't need God. I never get to a place where I don't need him. Even me, I'm anointed, I'm living holy, consecrated to the Lord. Holy means that I'm consecrated, I'm sold out to God. Amen.
Amen.
That means as a consequence of holiness, there's very little sin in my life.
Yes.
But how many know going on for my husband is a sin?
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So it's, but when you're in him, he convicts you. Jesus convicts you and say, girl, you know you're not right. How many know holding a grudge is wrong?
Amen.
My God.
Amen.
How many know holding unforgiveness in your heart is wrong?
Amen.
But when you're in God, when you're abiding in a secret place, God will pull your coat and say, you know that's not right.
That's
but
right.
The further you go away from God, the less you hear his voice. And God says, I need you to walk in relationship with me, but I always need you to be able to bow down at my feet.
Amen. That's
I need
right.
you to be able to come to me in your tears and come to me and cry and come to me and repent and come to me and say, God, I missed it. I messed up, God. I'm not coming to you like you owe me anything, but I messed up. I need you, God. Come on and give God some praise.
Amen.
Then you get the release.
Amen.
See, when you get to that place where you have a revelation of who he is and a realization of what he's done in your life, then you can get the release. That's where this woman got a release. She wasn't like them. She was a reject. She came in. She was a woman. My God. She wasn't welcome there. She came in and she threw herself at the feet of Jesus, and right away they attacked her and said, what is she doing here? If Jesus knew who she was, he wouldn't even let her touch him if he were really a prophet. Amen. Hallelujah. But Jesus said, leave this woman alone, because she has done what you haven't done. And she did it because she loves me and because she knows who I am. And Jesus said, you don't even know who I am. You don't even have a clue as to who I am.
Yes.
It was the religious leaders who were telling the woman that she was doing too much.
It was
the religious leaders who were telling the woman that she wasn't qualified to sit at the feet of Jesus. Amen. Don't let nobody stop you from worshiping God.
Amen.
Amen.
That's right.
Jesus said, she has done what you haven't done. She's done the right thing. He told the woman, your sins are forgiven. Go in peace.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Amen.
That word peace means prosperity. It means security. It means safety. It means the peace of the Messiah. Hallelujah. It means peace from dreading death or hell and damnation. Jesus told her right there, you're saved. Hallelujah. Go in peace. And that's what God is saying, that there's a release of peace, my God, when you abide at the feet of the Master. Hallelujah. There's a release of peace. Hallelujah. That means the devil can't harm you. The devil can't do anything to you that you're already victorious. Come on and give God some praise.
Yeah.
Because you got your peace. Tell somebody to look a little closer. Look a little closer. There's a release of the manifestation of who God has already called you to be. Somebody say, I'm walking into my release. Come on, somebody say, I'm walking into my breakthrough. Somebody say, I'm walking into my victory. Somebody say, I'm walking into everything God has for me. Come on and praise God, church. Come on, now, I'm walking into my release. Now, I'm walking into my breakthrough. Now, I'm walking into my victory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, I'm sitting at the feet of the Master.
Yeah.
I'm pressing my way in. I'm still messed up. in the Lord.
Amen.
Come on and praise God. Thank you, Lord. That's it, Lord. I thank you for breakthrough. Oh, glory. The burden is heavy sometimes, God. But she's walking in victory. Oh, glory. Mama, Koshele. Mama. Fill her, God. Afresh and anew, God. She has a revelation. She's like that woman. She is that woman. Oh, Mama, Koshele. Come on, pray, church. Pray. Pray for your sister's breakthrough. Pray for your breakthrough.
Break.
I break it off of her.
Break.
Anything that would hinder her destiny, I break. My Bakoshe, and I speak victory over her life. Glory, glory. I speak victory. God said, your eyes have not seen, Lord. Oh, nor have your ears heard the things I have in store for you. God says, you see things. And you don't really understand. He said, but you're in a season where I'm getting ready to give you revelation. Oh, there's a spirit that's an impartation. Oh, that I'm making at this altar today. Ha. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. A power. Oh, glory. The anointing of the Holy Ghost. Not from the woman, but from the Holy Spirit. The impartation is coming from me, says God. Not woman. It's not her. It's me. So, Lord, I thank you for anointing her with your power. Power. Oh, power. 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 Your power from on high. I thank you, Lord, for healing. I thank you, Lord, for deliverance. Something's happening in your belly. There's a birthing, my God, that's getting ready to take place. My God, well, God's birthing you from the old. I see you stepping out of the old and stepping into the new. And God says, oh, mama, I'm birthing you out to who I created you to be. Oh, glory. And the pain and the depression, the frustration, the fear, you're leaving it behind. I see it all being left behind. And I thank you, Lord, for this warrior. God said, you're a warrior. You're a warrior. I called you to be a warrior. And I thank you for this warrior and what you have over her life. So continue to have your way. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Come on,
amen. Amen.
Come on, praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. And we praise you. Hallelujah. For this woman of God, for this yielded vessel. Lord, we thank you for her life and what you're doing in her life. Lord, I thank you, even as we say, look a little closer. That you're doing, even I see God taking you from faith to faith and glory to glory. God says, I'm taking you into newer realms for me. Hallelujah. And you and your sister, my God, God said there's a covenant connection, my God, where there's been warfare and opposition to try to come against what I birthed out in you and her for so many years. And God said, I break it off of you in Jesus' name. And I push you. I see you propelling. It's like a whirlwind. Like a whirlwind going on in your life. So much is going on. And God said, you feel like you're in the middle of that whirlwind. You go around and around and around and around and around. But God says, you're coming out unscathed. You're coming out untouched. You're coming out with victory. You're in the middle of it. But God said, because you praise me in the middle of it, your victory is already. It's already. I said, it's already. I just hear God say, it's already done. Is already done. You're going to be able to speak some things. Oh, and watch them manifest. Oh, God says, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth and begin to speak to those things that are trying to approach you. In Jesus' mighty name. So, Lord, I thank you for this vessel, this yielded vessel. I thank you for what you're doing in her life. I thank you for breakthrough. I thank you, Lord. My mama cool shit. I speak breakthrough over her life right now. Baba, push it, Baba. In the name of Jesus, breakthrough.
Come on, put your blessed hands together. Give God a hand clap of praise for the word.